Good morning, and welcome to the historic Basilica Cathedral of St. John the Baptist. We welcome all of you present and those joining us through live stream. We pray that you are in good health. We ask that all during the ongoing pandemic continue to use hand sanitizers and maintain a distance of 2 meters. Masks are recommended but not mandatory. For communion, please follow the usher's directions and sanitize your hands before receiving Holy Communion. Thank you.
Friends, just as we begin, I received a phone message just before the Mass from Sandra, who was so hoping to be here, but she mentioned that this morning she tested positive for COVID, so she's unable to be here for Jimmy's funeral, but she will be able to join us by watching by live stream. So she'll be with us, and we'll keep her in our prayers as well in this Holy Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, on the day of his baptism, Jimmy was welcomed into the church, given new life in Christ, and clothed with the garment of salvation. Today we greet the remains of our brother and surround him with the church's prayer. We commend our brother Jimmy to the mercy of God and pray that the promise made to him in baptism will be fulfilled.
Our opening hymn this morning can be found in your Catholic Book of Worship, 481, Be Not Afraid. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you. Through raging waters in the sea. if you walk amidst the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross and was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Jimmy, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. I invite you to please be seated and we'll have the first reading.
The first reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, I am about to create new heavens and a new earth. The former things shall not be remembered or come to mind, but be glad and rejoice forever in what I am creating. For I am about to create Jerusalem as a joy and its people as a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and delight in my people. No more shall the sound of weeping be heard in it, or the cry of distress. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to our psalm this morning, the Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do I want.
The Lord is
is my shepherd, and nothing do I want. The Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do I want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing that I lack. In fresh green pastures he bids me lie. He leads me to a watercourse where I may rest, and he restores my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do I want. He leads me on my trail, straight and sure, for the honor of his name. If I should tread a valley dark with shade, no evil will I fear, for you are with me. Your rod and staff, these comfort me. The Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do I want. You spread before me a feast for all my foes to see. My head you do anoint with oil, my cup is brimming full. The Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do I want. Indeed, his grace and kindness will follow me through all the days of my life, and I shall live in the house of the Lord for many years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do give glory to the Father and the Son. Give glory to the Holy Spirit. As in the beginning, so now and evermore, throughout eternity. The Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do I want.
We'll now have the second reading.
The second reading is from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. I may be able to speak the languages of men and women, and even of angels, but if I have no love, my speech is no more than a noisy gong or a clanging bell. I may have the gift of inspired preaching. I may have all knowledge and understand all secrets. I may have all the faith needed to move mountains, but if I have no love, I am nothing. I may give away everything I have and even offer my body to be burnt. But if I have no love, this does me no good. Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fail. Love is eternal. There are inspired messages, but they are temporary. There are gifts of speaking in strange tongues, but they will cease. There is knowledge, but it will pass. For our gifts of knowledge and of inspired messages are only partial. But when what is perfect comes, then what is partial will disappear. When I was a youth, my speech, feelings, and thinking were all those of a child. Now that I am a man, I have no more use for childish ways. What we see now is like a dim image in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. What I know now is only partial. Then it will be complete as God's knowledge of me. Meanwhile, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Stand for the gospel.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Through the words of the gospel, may our sins be wiped away. You may be seated for a few moments. My dear friends, just first of all, on behalf of the Basilica Parish community and Father Critch, I just want to offer our condolences to all of Jimmy's family and friends, those who are gathered here today and those who can't be here. I know Sandra really wanted to be here, and having come down with COVID this morning, she can't, and thanks be to God she's able to join us by live stream. So that's a consolation for us this morning. I wasn't, I know you had gatherings at the funeral home yesterday, and myself, I'm just having gotten over COVID myself, so I wasn't able to visit with you personally yesterday, many of the family members at the funeral home. But one thing I did is just take some time looking through the many comments that were left on the funeral home webpage about the many people and how they appreciated Jimmy, how they remembered his laugh and his smile. They remembered how pleasant he was, how loving he was. People spoke of the many things that he enjoyed doing, playing darts with the hub, music, dancing. Also during the day yesterday, I had a very touching conversation with Sandra about her brother, and she shared with me a number of things in her close relationship with Jimmy. On the one hand, she shared with me many of the struggles that Jimmy experienced throughout his life, especially those that resulted from Down syndrome and the disabilities and the difficulties that can come along with that. But also on the other hand, she shared with me so many of the good memories that her and Jimmy had together, the trips that they shared, the visits they had together, the time that they spent together, Christmases and other occasions that they shared together. And perhaps what touched me the most was she shared just simply the bond of love that they shared with one another. Oftentimes, when we think of somebody with a disability in our lives, sometimes what people think of, first of all, is the things that they can't do or are limited in doing in life. But thanks be to God, love is not prevented by a disability. And in fact, love is oftentimes deepened by it. That bond of love can be deepened. Over my years, as a priest and beforehand, I've had the privilege in many ways of having many different friends and accompanying families who have a family member, a sibling, or a child who bears some kind of disability. And oftentimes the outward world focuses on the hardships that that can entail. However, the presence in our life of somebody with any kind of disability can be a most precious gift for us. It can be a precious gift to a family. One thing that comes to my mind often before I, one of my first assignments as a parish priest was in Marystown on the Buren Peninsula. I followed Father Critch's footsteps there, in fact. And in our parish, we had a teenage boy, Ethan,
And Ethan had Down syndrome. And just about every Sunday, Ethan faithfully served on the altar at Mass. And Ethan was by far the most cherished member of our parish community. And everybody's hearts just warmed and glowed whenever Ethan came into Mass. And he was just loved and cherished in a special way by all of the parishioners. He was a light to all of us in the Marystown Parish. One of the great gifts that a disabled person can bring into our lives is that they have a tendency to remind us of a great and profound mystery of human dignity. What I mean by that is they can remind us that the value of human life does not depend upon how healthy we are. It doesn't depend on how smart or brilliant we are. It doesn't depend on how successful or well off we are. There's a value of human life that is far deeper than all of this. It's not something that depends on what we achieve in life, but it's a dignity that comes directly from God. And every single person can share in this dignity from the very moment of their conception to death, no matter what we can or cannot do in life. And it's important for all of us to be reminded of this in some way or another, to be reminded of how unique and how precious and how sacred every single human life is. It's especially helpful right now when we're surrounded by a culture that tends to prize health and success above all of the other goods in life. Those are not the greatest things. God's love for us and our worth as human beings is far more profound than all of that. When preparing for the funeral mass this morning, I chose the gospel reading of the Beatitudes, a well-known gospel reading. We hear a series of statements by our Lord about what are the conditions of true happiness in this life and the next. What you'll find amongst many of those statements is what is remarkable is that oftentimes they're precisely what we don't expect. Our Lord says things like, blessed are the poor in spirit, blessed are those who mourn, blessed are the meek, etc. Those statements of our Lord reveal to us that it's often those who suffer are considered the most blessed in the eyes of God. Those are the ones who are the most dependent upon God. At least those are the ones who realize sometimes that they're the most dependent upon God. We're all dependent upon God, whether we realize it or not. Often the ones who suffer are the humblest. Often the ones who suffer are the simplest. Often are the most pure in heart. The Lord does not say, blessed are the healthy. He doesn't say, blessed are the rich. He doesn't say, blessed are the successful. And what you see is that our Lord gives his special promises and his special care and attention to the little ones who suffer. You watch it unfold up and down the pages of the scriptures. It's precisely those who struggle with some form of disability are the ones who hold a special place in our Lord's heart. And he goes out of his way to give sight to the blind, to help the lame and the crippled walk, to heal the sick, to help the deaf hear and the mute speak, and on and on. Those who were disabled were special objects of our Lord's concern and his care. In fact, it was the very disability that they had that brought Jesus to them and brought them to Jesus. So today we offer this funeral mass for Jimmy. We know that his life was very precious in the eyes of the Lord. We entrust Jimmy now into the merciful care of the Lord Jesus. We pray Jimmy will enjoy eternal life, where there will be no more sickness or suffering, but where our Lord will make everything new, as we heard in the first reading. We give thanks to the Lord for Jimmy's life and the great lessons that his life and his love can teach us. And we pray for ourselves that we may grow to understand more deeply that the value of our life, of all human life, is not based on the things that we accomplish, but it's based upon the love of God, the love of God who created us and who redeemed us. And the reason we're here today now, and that we hope of, have hope of a future to come and a hope of the resurrection and eternal life, is precisely because of this love of God. God bless you all this morning. Friends, I invite you to please stand for the prayers of the faithful. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Jimmy received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Jimmy was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer unjustly, and grant them and gather them into the kingdom of eternal peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Jimmy seek comfort and consolation. Heed their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled in faith and confidence to pray for our brother, Jimmy. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to please be seated now. We'll have the offertory procession.
send you forever.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Jimmy, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
I invite you to please kneel if you're able. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John the Baptist, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My friends, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual communion for those viewing online and for those who cannot receive Holy Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come, at least spiritually, into my heart. I embrace you, for you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For the reception of Holy Communion, we ask that you please remain standing in your pew until invited forward by an usher. Maintain a 2-meter distance in the communion line and sanitize your hands before receiving Holy Communion. Thank you. Our communion hymn, The Last Supper. Jesus took the bread he broke. Jesus shared the bread he broke and said, do this in memory of me. Jesus took the wine he poured. Jesus shared the wine he poured and said, do this in memory of me. I am the vine, you are the branches, and all who live in me will bear great fruit. Jesus took the bread he broke. Jesus shared the bread he broke and said, do this in memory of me. Jesus took the wine he poured. Jesus shared the wine he poured and said, do this in memory of me.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now. the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quite light, morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. You were chosen for the Son. You were chosen from all women. And for woman, shining one, gentle woman, quiet light, morning star. Strong and bright, gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. Blessed are you among women, blessed in turn, all women too. Blessed they with peaceful spirits, blessed they. With gentle hearts, gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us
love. Let us pray.
Lord,
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Jimmy may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Jimmy shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May he be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our brother Jimmy, we let this incense rise to God, who has called him to share in his glory. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Jimmy. In the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Jimmy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. Amen. Amen. My dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. And in peace now, let us take our brother to his place of rest. Amen.
Our missioning hymn this morning, number 554 in your Catholic Book of Worship, How Great Thou Art.
Have made I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great. Forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and there the brook, and feel the gentle breeze. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great.